Let's look at the solution to our block size quiz. We have a 32 kilobyte cache with 64 byte block size and a program that accesses n variables that have lots of temporal locality, meaning each of these variables is accessed often in the program, but no spatial locality, meaning they are nowhere close to each other. The question is, what is the largest n, the number of these variables, that still results in a high hit rate? Now, x1, when we bring it into the cache, we will bring an entire block worth of stuff around it, and because there is no spatial locality, that means that none of the other variables will be in that block. When we access x2, same thing, we will bring 64 bytes worth of stuff that doesn't include any of the other variables. So every time we access one of these variables, we will need 64 bytes worth of space in the cache. If we want to have a high hit rate, because these variables have lots of temporal locality, we want all of them to remain in the cache. That is, we want all of them to fit in the cache. So the largest n that still results in the high hit rate is how many blocks can we fit in our cache, really? It's a 32 kilobyte cache. There are 64 byte blocks. How many blocks do we have? So the answer is 32 kilobytes divided by 64 bytes, which gives us 512. So the answer here is 512. If we have 512 or fewer variables, then the fact that each one of them has its own cache block in the cache, although the variable is probably only 4 bytes in size, is not going to hurt us in terms of hit rate. But if we have more than 512 variables, then even though there is plenty of space in the cache, if it's 4-byte variables, 512 variables is 2 kilobytes worth of actual stuff that we are using. The block is much larger than that, but because we are fetching an entire block when we have a miss, we will not have a good hit rate if we have more than 512 of these variables. In order to be able to have more variables than this, we really need them to be close to each other so that we can benefit from spatial locality, meaning that a block we fetch for one variable needs to include some of the other variables.